And so I'm speaking again today with Paul Beckwith. Thank you, Paul. Thanks for joining me.
Well, thanks for asking me. It's always a pleasure to have a conversation with you, Stuart.
Well, I don't know if it's pure pleasure because we get into some pretty heavy spaces sometimes, but it is. You and I derive meaning in our lives, if I can say for you, I can say for myself, from trying to help humanity understand what's going on.
Yes. Yes, whether it be climate or some other catastrophe, you know, pandemic or global pandemic, for example.
Yeah. Forest fires or floods, which many people don't see as related to climate change. I will say that you are an associate professor with the University of Ottawa, is it?
Well, part-time professor. So I teach various courses when I, you know, it's sort of contract basis.
I see. And I call myself a professor without borders. I used to teach college and university, but I quit my day job teaching, college teaching in order to do this climate work full time.
Yeah. And of course, funny enough, I mean, all the universities are going, you know, online. Doing online teaching now, right? So I'm expecting U of O to contact me, University of Ottawa to contact me and say, we need help. You know, you've been doing this for years yourself.
Right. Well, and you probably, and actually, if you wanted to be merciful to them, you could, you know, call them and say, you guys need a little help lately.
I will do that.
By contrast, I refused for years to do online courses because there was something that I knew was important in the physical presence that you don't get over the internet. And the way I explain it is, it could be explained in physical terms that you can tell when people by gestures and facial expressions, when people in your class don't understand what you're saying.
Right,
but you can also tell when your back is facing the class if somebody is not getting it.
Yes,
if you're sensitive, and that gets us into the realm of woo telepathy. That is being sensitive to the emotional tenor, the temperament that's in the room.
You know? Oh, I thought you were talking about a mirror on the blackboard, maybe.
No, I
yeah.
It's clear to me that there is, as I've quoted in the last 24 hours, I quote Hamlet a lot, there is more in heaven and earth than is dreamt of in your philosophy, Horatio.
Yes, absolutely.
I think I got it. So much, Horatio in the wrong place.
Well, there's so much we don't understand, right? I mean, it is very different in a classroom. I mean, you get the feedback sort of right away from the students and, you know, I like walking around, you know, the classroom as I'm speaking. I'm not always at the front, whereas, if, you know, I'm not going to walk off camera. Yeah. I'm doing it online. I'm kind of tied to my seat.
Exactly. But, you know, the other thing, though, is that for online and for this particular teaching that we're doing today, there's always contact@scientistswarning.tv, which we put on all of our videos. Well, most of our videos. When I'm packaging someone else's material, sometimes I leave that part out because we have our hands full working with an all-volunteer team dealing with the comments and questions just for our own material, no less for the material that I borrow from any of the talks that Greta Thunberg gives around.
Anyway, you're looking very spiffy there, you know, with your jacket and tie, and you're looking very good, you know, lots of color.
I put this on intentionally, and I'll say it aside, and we'll get it edited out. But I want people to understand, just in a moment, that this is official. If you and I had talked ahead of time, if we'd planned this far ahead of time, I would have said, have that bookcase right behind your head and have a collar shirt. But you're in Canada and it's probably cold there. It's somewhere between cold and insanely cold. And we can verify that in a moment by ourselves by sharing the earth.null school.
Right, yes.
With null school, which I'm putting that in little bits in. I'm going to do three conversations today. One with Raymond Ford. That's the first one the first one I scheduled was with Peter Wadhams, and that's going to happen tonight, my time.
Ah, okay.
Tomorrow morning, his time. Sunday morning, his time. And he's in Italy now.
He is still in Italy, yeah. Is he in Milan or where is he? You know,
it's near Milan. It's called Ancona.
And of course, we know what's going on. You know, the horrible news from Italy, the triaging, not enough equipment, you know, the ICU, intensive care units, and it's just horrible. And now, you know, just yesterday, Norway went under lockdown. And today it was Spain. You know, Madrid, you know, is a hotbed for this virus.
Yep.
So
yep.
You'll be interested to know, I got a recording from our friend Alfonso.
Oh, yes.
Let's mention
how we know him. Alfonso volunteered to give you lodging when you were both in Madrid for the last Climate Talks, COP25. But he also went on to be a very valuable teammate. So
yes, very, very valuable.
What was it that he told you?
Well, he said they're on shifts. He's an air traffic controller, and they put them with teams. So they only work with the same people all the time. So they get to know each other very well. They don't shift teams. And they're on for 2 weeks, off for 2 weeks. So he's off for 2 weeks. So he went up to the you know, remote areas. He's got a cabin and basically fishing, from what I can tell. And he seems very happy. Yeah.
Now, I'm happy that he's somewhere relaxing. When he's fishing, I don't want to provoke the ire of animal rights people.
Well, he didn't actually say fishing. I know he loves fishing, and I know there's streams there, so I know he's fishing. But he said it was for relaxation, for reading, for meditating. But you know, it's near rivers at Alfonso. You know, I mean, he throws them all back. It's just for the fun of it, right?
Oh, okay. And catch him.
Yeah, and he does an awful lot of work for you know, preserving the quality of the streams, like a lot of small dams appear and things like that. So
well, we know
illegally.
He's a very sensitive being, and I'm not worried about him abusing nature.
No,
you know, as humanity collectively is abusing nature. But anyhow,
yes. So, but I, you know, there was a report today. The Prime Minister of Spain, his wife tested positive for the coronavirus. And so that's the same as Canada. Justin Trudeau's wife, Sophia, she was in London and she tested positive. She came back from London, I believe, last weekend. And she was with her kids and her husband, Justin Trudeau, for 3 or 4 days. And then it was, you know, she got symptoms after about three or four days and tested positive.
My God. So Trudeau more than likely has it.
Well, I think he and his kids more likely have it. I'm not sure if that will become out in the public, especially if he has very mild symptoms. I don't know. I think it should come out. He's an honest, you know, I don't think he'd probably hide it, but, you know, maybe the security people, maybe they're saying no for national security reasons. Yes.
We can't. He hasn't been
tested. And of course, you know, Trump was claiming that he was tested and he's clear tonight. This was a news. I mean, this is the coronavirus thing is evolving extremely rapidly. Like if you don't, you know, if you're not addicted to news, you don't know all of these things. It's changing on an hourly basis, right?
I'm not addicted to news. On the contrary, I prefer not to be glued to the news. Every once in a while, I'll check the Associated Press news feeds. And I only check headlines or unless there's a very interesting article.
But
in any case, the news is not good about pandemics, but you and I are part of the alt news media, alternative viewpoint. And you have your channel and I have got my channel. And we'll both be putting this out on our channels, because we really need, especially now, desperately need to educate people. And what I'm saying is we need to get them to connect the dots between the current coronavirus outbreak and climate change.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes. And also in the really short term, you know, immediate term, we need to, countries are making mistakes left, right, and center.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they're not, you know, and the difference between acting and locking down a country, shutting it down basically one day to the next, can make an enormous difference on the outcome because of the rapidity of this virus.
Let me
Just saying, the UK and the US are in deep, deep trouble because they're, the UK is talking about herd immunity, which is absolutely insane. You know, this is Boris Johnson's view. You know,
herd just, community. What do you mean?
Herd immunity. Herd immunity. He's saying, you know, let the thing come and do its damage on us, and then, you know, a lot of us will get immunity to it. We'll get infected. We'll get immunity. We'll survive, and then it will be out of our system quickly.
Insane.
Which is insane. I mean, people talk about